Welcome to this short video on the Create Grading Command, which is part of the Kobi Toolkit for Civil 3D 2020. To get started here, we're going to come up here to the Kobi Toolkit for Civil 3D ribbon. We're going to come over to the surface grading, and we're going to select Create Grading. At the command line, it says select your entity, which is my polyline. So we can select a polyline, a 3D polyline, or a feature line. So I'm going to select the polyline. It says pick your grading size, so I'm going to pick to the outside. It says enter the length, so I could start to do a transitioning in here. So let's go, let's just grade from here. I'm going to grade on around here. And if you really want to go in the other direction, all you have to do is press enter to change that direction. You can say, let's grade around this area here. So I'm going to pick, and that's the area I'm going to grade. And as you can see, it automatically graded because we create templates. And so I have two templates already in here. I got a template one, I got a template two. So if I change it, you can see it automatically change. What I want to do is I want to create my own. So let's go ahead and delete both of these out of here. We're going to start from scratch. Let's click on the plus sign. First thing I want to do is I want to do an offset and slope. So I can change all these formats here. Let's go offset and slope. My slope format I'm going to use is a percentage. And my slope I'm going to put in here is a negative 10. And my offset, I'm going to say, let's go out here 15 feet. And there you can see it. Now I want to grade down to the surface from there. So let's go ahead and hit the plus sign. I'm going to go offset or slope to surface. My format is 1:1 or whatever. I'm going to go cut slope here. I'm going to say my cut slope is going to be 2:1. And my fill slope is going to be 3:1. And then you can also pick your surface name, and so I've only got one surface in there that I'm grading to. Now, just to show you a couple other features in here, we have a new feature called Draw Grading Transitions. What this will allow me to do is I can transition this entire length of the grading. So for instance, here I might want to grade this out at 15 feet, but over here I might only want to go 5 foot. So if I click on this Draw Grading Transition, you can see it updates automatically. So if I come back up to the offset and slope, you'll now see I've got a slope start, a slope end, an offset start, and an offset end. So my slope start is negative 10. I'm gonna say my slope end, I'll keep that also at a negative 10, but I'm gonna change my slope start. I've got that set at 15. My offset end, I'm gonna say, let's change that to 5. Click there, and now you'll see it update. So this is 15. And that's 5 there. Looking at some other features here, we got draw grading surface. So I automatically want to create a surface when I'm done. So I can specify the surface style. If I've gone all the way around, I can automatically do the infill. So that's what that's telling you. If I go into the options here, we've got our sampling interval, our angular spacing, and the mid ordinate distance for curve tessellations. Just showing you the accuracy you're going to get on the surface here. Our slope, we're going to go rise over run. We're going to say draw rays, which is going to be lines showing us where we're grading to. We're going to join the surfaces. If I didn't have that checked, I would get a separate surface for this grading and a separate surface for the outside grading, but I want them all joined together. And then the last thing is I want to enable grips, and I'll show you that in a moment. So it's okay here. Now I want to save this so I don't have to do this every single time. So let's hit the plus sign here, and I'm just going to type in 3. I'm going to go okay. So I've saved that grading, but what I'm going to do here in this case is I'm going to take off the draw grading transitions. I don't really want to do that in this situation. So I'm just going to go okay. What happens there is now you can see the surface is automatically created. If I select on the surface now, you're going to see these grips. What these grips allow you to do is be able to manipulate the grading. So if I slide this out, as you can see here, you can see the outside grading to the surface is changing. And I'm changing the slopes in this case here in order to just go out farther. If I use this one, this is changing the inside slope. So you can see how dynamic that is. So let's slide this on up. I pick, and now there's the finished product. So if I grab this surface here, I'll go to Object Viewer, and there you can see what I've done. I'll exit this, and this concludes this short video on the Create Grading Tool, which is part of Kobi Toolkit for Civil 3D 2020.